In previous videos, you have been exposed to various tools dealing with timeline-based compositing. This layer-based approach is very good for a lot of tasks, but sometimes you need more advanced compositing tools to take on challenging design and visual effects. In this video, you will look at the node-based compositing workflow known as ConnectFX. To access ConnectFX, you select a segment in the sequence. You can click the Effects button or right-click on the segment and choose Add Effect. You can also press Ctrl+Tab to bring up the Effects ribbon. Now choose Create ConnectFX. You are now transported from the timeline into the ConnectFX environment, which some of you might know as node compositing. For those of you who have never seen something like this before, procedural node compositing represents visual effects pipelines. In essence, you connect effects in a branch-like structure that come together to form a composited result. One advantage of ConnectFX is that you can visually track the processes being applied to your images by tracing the node tree. This means you can spot problems easier through the effects connections. So for difficult challenges, you can reorder effects to change the effects pipeline. This gives you more options to solve any creative or technical tasks in ConnectFX. The first thing I'd like to point out is that your timeline segment has been loaded as a source node. This is connected to the CFX output node. The result of the ConnectFX output is what you will ultimately see in the sequence. In a later video, you will see what happens when you bring in multiple video tracks into ConnectFX. Looking to the left of the interface is the media panel. The media panel enables you to grab any source clip or multiple clips and drag them into the ConnectFX schematic. The clip or clips can now be composited as part of the ConnectFX branch. A new section also appears in the media panel above the libraries. This is called CFX. This section enables you to monitor the sources you use in ConnectFX. You can also drag sources into a library folder if you want to use them somewhere else. There is also a filter tab at the top of the media panel that allows you just to focus on the CFX sources. If the interface feels a bit cramped, you can hide the media panel by using the pull-down menu or pressing one left arrow. The same keyboard shortcut will bring the media panel back. Earlier, I used the term ConnectFX schematic. This refers to the view that shows the branch of nodes connected together. The other viewer is the result view. This shows the output of each node when you select it in the ConnectFX schematic. The bar beneath the viewers contains the viewer controls and tool selection. You can also look at ConnectFX using different viewer layouts. For example, using a 3-up view, you could split the interface to see the ConnectFX schematic, a particular node's result, and the end result all at the same time. You can choose the viewer layout, as well as decide what you see in each viewer using the View menu. The viewer layouts are mapped to option 1, 2, 3, and 4 for the number of views you want. Just remember to select the viewer by clicking on it, and then adjust the View menu. Notice that the selected viewer has a thicker outline. The Tools pull-down menu has the selection and navigation controls for the viewer. It will also dynamically update with different cursors depending where you are and what node you are working with. Finally, there is one important button to be aware of. To the bottom left of the interface is the Effects node. This button will allow you to toggle between the main ConnectFX node bin and the current node you are working with. Beneath the middle toolbar, there is another grey bar containing more general ConnectFX functions. This includes the player and time bar controls, grids and view menus, load and save buttons, and last but certainly not least, render and exit ConnectFX. The remainder of the interface is dedicated to the controls that dynamically change as you move through the ConnectFX environment. The starting point for any composite is the ConnectFX node bin. You can access it by clicking on the Effects node button. The large node bin is where you will find all your nodes for task and effects creation. There is also a lot of nodes to choose from, and you can scrub the bin from left to right to reveal more tools. To make it easy to find a specific tool, simply type the first letter of the tool on your keyboard and it will be highlighted in the node bin. So for example, I will type C. Next, I will drag a color correction node into the ConnectFX schematic. You could also double-click on any node to add it into the ConnectFX schematic. To insert the color correction node into an existing branch, hold Option and hover the node over the connection. When you release the cursor, the node auto-inserts into the connection. If you want the nodes to auto-insert by default without keyboard shortcuts, go to the CFX Preferences menu and enable Auto-Insert option. To pull a node out of an existing connection, hold Option Command and pull out the node. I'll reinsert this node back into the branch. Let's have a closer look at the colors surrounding the nodes. To understand the structure of a node, bear in mind that the compositing branch always travels from left to right. So looking at a typical node in ConnectFX, the left side of the node is always the inputs, and the right side of the node is always the outputs. For example, the color correction node has three inputs and one output. The red input typically represents a front or foreground. The green input typically represents a back or background. And the blue input typically represents a matte or alpha input. This allows you to key or limit the region of a specific effect. The single output from the color correction node is known as the result output. You can also get a blue output from a node, and this indicates a matte or alpha output. These inputs and outputs will vary depending on the nodes, but this is the general gist of how the nodes are laid out. To access any node's parameters or tools, double-click on them to update the interface. For example, selecting a source node displays the basic menu, resizing menu, and color management menu. When you select the color correction node, it will display the color correction toolset. However, the controls on the left and right of the interface are generic and very seldom update. Let's focus on the controls to the left of the interface. Here you can access the ConnectFX preferences, the selected nodes preferences, the animation editor, which you saw in the animation videos. And finally, you have the timing view. The timing view displays all your sources in ConnectFX as segments in the timeline view. Please be aware that this is not an editorial timeline. The purpose of this is that you can see and manipulate the starting time of each source. So you can adjust the starting times of different sources using the offset slider. A couple more tips before you get started experimenting with ConnectFX. Earlier, you saw how to insert a node into an existing node branch. If you were joining a node to a branch, you could drag a connection from the output into the input of the node. To break the link, simply click and draw a line across the connection. A faster way to connect the nodes is to kiss them. Hold Option and drag the nodes towards each other. When the output and inputs touch, the connection forms between them. To move the nodes around the ConnectFX schematic, you can either shift-click a node to select it and all the nodes downstream, or hold Command and drag a box selection around the nodes. Whichever nodes are selected can be moved around with the cursor. Double-clicking anywhere else in the schematic deselects the node. Right-clicking on any node or a multiple node selection will bring up the pop-up menu. Here you will find a list of commands to work with the nodes. Once you are done, you can exit ConnectFX and you will be returned back to the sequence. You can press render at this point, but at any time, you can return into the ConnectFX and continue tweaking your composites. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.